I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Central Valley. It's Riley and Danny here with your announcements for today, March 7th, 2018.
The lunch for today is a chili cheese dog.
The Greater Pittsburgh Area Food Banks have volunteer opportunities available on Saturdays at their Pittsburgh area location. Please email Mrs. Jones if interested.
Attention all seniors. All senior project paperwork is due Monday, April 1st. This includes all items in the senior project packet, including the contract, mentor form, hours log, job shadow form, resume, and essay. The visual aid is due on April 20th, the day senior projects will be presented. All paperwork may be turned in early to Mrs. Jones or Mrs. Kostelik.
The tickets for the Central Valley musical, All Shook Up, are on sale. Adult tickets are $10 and student tickets are $9. Tickets can be purchased at the high school office or at the door the night of the show.
On March 14th, the Peace Club will host a candlelight memorial service and lantern release to honor the lives lost in the Parkland shooting. It will take place at the CVHS throwing fields and arrival is at 6 p.m. The lighting of the candles and lantern release will take place at 6:45. Families of the community are welcome and donations for Stoneman Douglas High School will be accepted. Everyone will receive a candle and 17 lanterns will be released in honor of the 17 lives lost. For any further questions, contact Corinne Krasternova.
The girls basketball team will take on Forest Hills High School on Saturday in the first round of state playoffs. They will play at Cambria High School at 4:00.
Starting tomorrow, the cafeteria will offer an MTO sandwich and salad line. Choice meats and cheeses, fresh vegetables, and a variety of bread options will be available daily. Stop in and try this exciting new lunch option Thursday or Friday for a chance to win a $25 gift card.
That's all we have for you today, CV. Now here's Preston and Nico with a special segment.
Good morning, Central Valley. Preston and Nico here with your word of the week. Nico, please tell me you have a good word for today.
Of course I do, Preston. This week's word is emulate.
What does that mean?
Emulate, to copy or try to do better.
Can you use it in a sentence for me?
Preston tries to emulate my style because he thinks I'm so cool.
Ha! You're funny, Nico, but today must be opposite day because I never want to be like you. That's all we have for today, CB. Have a great day.
Hey CV, it's Michael and Nathan here with a segment on Career Day.
Career Day occurred on February 22nd. We had a plethora of people here teaching you about what they do.
Career Day was so informational that we decided to go around and film some of the more popular sessions.
Here's a look at some of the footage that we got.
Went to Pitt, went into into the bachelor's program there. I sat for my state board and I became a registered nurse. So I sat for the same ones. Then I went on for my education and I received
what they're planning or what your habits are. A lot of people don't read the newspaper anymore. It's unfortunately a thing. And so, putting advertising in newspapers is not, what a lot of people are doing anymore. And so there's a whole big,
Personally, that's something that I'll always cherish. A guy who has had success in the NFL, Darrell Revis from Aliquippi, broadcasted his games. Robert Foster went to Alabama, won a couple national championships.
Well, you know, we love that place. No, it's not. It's Flagship University. It's in Dallas-Fort Worth, okay? That's a full-on university that we have for in-flight, for flight attendant training and pilot training. It's all done there. So you're there for 6 weeks. We give you room and board, but we do not give you...
So, a couple things to remember here, right? So you earn while you learn. You go to school in the evening, and then during the day you work for a contractor out on the various different jobs. So you're getting paid, and you're going to school when the schooling isn't costing you any money.
I never took these kind of classes.
I'm using this, I'm all spread out. I will go ahead and get started. My name is Erica, and I am a registered dietitian. I currently work for Heritage Valley. I work in their community health services department, and my title is lifestyle coach coordinator, and that's just a really fancy term for health educator. So basically,
with all the regulations these days with the insurance companies and everything, you've got to be very detailed in your notes with each visit that someone comes in. So with doing like an evaluation of a new patient, you're working with the notes probably like 15, 20 minutes for one note. So it's pretty comprehensive with that. But like I said, it's worth it when you're working with the patients.
You got it. Yeah. See? Hey, he gets a star. You have him in class, give him 10 points bonus.
Hell yeah, I'm studying off. Can't do much for that.
Let him out early.
Yeah.
We can't do anymore. He gets to use the race. You guys use the race to go to the bathroom?
Sure.
You get to go 10 minutes longer.
Teaching people. So you get to go to a new institution, you get to teach residents and medical students what you learn at your place and how you did things at your place. So it's a very, very interesting thing. Also, you're not a little lowly resident anymore, and that's kind of a nice thing because for the last 5 years you've been treated as kind of being lower on the totem pole. As a fellow, you're seeing a little bit.
Thank you. My name's Trooper Keston. Came down here, glad to be here today, talk to you. Any of you want to be police officers someday? Troopers, you got one there? Maybe you, all right. And maybe you, so about half of you, that's good. All right, there's a process to go through to being any type of police officer. I know pretty familiar with the, you know, the process of becoming a Pennsylvania State Trooper, so.
I think when I say strong union support is I think everyone deserves a fair wage. I think everyone deserves a safe place to go to work. And by meaning a safe place to go to work and a safe environment to go to work.
So
you're talking about public safety. You're talking about public employees.
Yeah, so public employees, and then there was also in Detroit, that they had unions for the automakers, they had unions for all the factory workers, and
right.
Eventually the union got so powerful that the automakers were heavily, heavily hindered from doing anything by off time, paid leave. They had up to a month, a year from paid vacation.
What's wrong with having 4 weeks vacation?
At a certain point, it's not a company's obligation to give you 4 months vacation.
Why not?
Because they have to make profits. They're both.
But without the employee, how do they make their profit?
Well, the employee is there. The employee is getting a wage from them. That's what's there.
Right, but at one point, compensation was salary, benefits, and vacation. Somewhere along the line, the discussion shifted where it's just salary.
Overall, Career Day was a success. Although we didn't get film of every speaker, we hope you guys got some important information on your future.
Thanks, CB. Have a great day.